Welcome to Real Experiences with APIs in Treasury. In this session, Damien Glendinning will be talking to John Lawrence and Mark Troutman in our first episode entitled Business is Changing, Treasury Needs to Adapt. Over to you, Damien.
Well, thank you, Rupert, and big thanks to John and Mark for joining us today. Quick background to this session is that last year we did a series on technology and how the new technology is enabling real-time treasury and a big change in the way we work, hopefully leading to things like the elimination of reconciliations and so on. The feedback we got from our members was that's all great, but at the end of the day, we are passengers on the bus, as one big person put it. We don't control the IT budget or the IT direction. So we thought it'd be great to talk to John and Mark, who have extensive experience of implementing these things. And of course, they both have big experience with DBS, but before that, they were both with HSBC for a long period of time in senior positions. And John also has experience with Citi. So we're talking about two people here who have really good background and experience in this. And again, thank you for joining. Hear about APIs and so on. But at the end of the day, and we understand how these are very important if you are facing consumers, so they're very much B2C kind of things. But our business is B2B, so it doesn't really apply to us. So, John, I know you have a strong view on that. It'd be great if you could share that with us.
Yes, thank you, Damien. Look, I think it's pretty evident why, you know, there might be a view that the use of API connectivity is, you know, provides sort of primarily the value add in the B2C space. However, we do see application in the B2B space. And I think, you know, to give an example, as commercial enterprises are looking to take advantage of digitalization, you know, new technology, new forms of connectivity, businesses are looking to create new commercial models or to create adjacent revenue models. So one example that comes to mind immediately is work that we did with a large container shipping line. And they could see that they have significant amounts of data relating to the containers that they ship from, you know, country A to B and have done for years, information on exporters, particularly SME exporters that perhaps find it more difficult to get hold of financing. And so they had decided to go down the path of creating a trade finance adjacent revenue stream. So to finance goods that are sitting on their ships, you know, having the information from the past track records of exporters and so on. In order to create that trade finance business within the shipping line, clearly that required as part of that product development, you know, the, if you like, the financial components that sat within that new trade finance capability. So elements of escrow arrangements, determining whether financing would be taken or not for a particular shipment, and then obviously the actual settlement between the parties involved. So whilst that might have come out of the commercial side of the business looking for to create an adjacent revenue model, clearly the implications for the treasury organization of that shipping company were quite profound. And if you just look at the risks and payment processes that the proposition was fundamentally built upon, I think hopefully that gives an example of where this is, you know, also relevant in terms of B2B. This particular solution would not have become a reality if it wasn't for API-based connectivity.
And I think you have another experience involving an insurance company with how it's all about customer experience at the end of the day.
Yes, absolutely. I think another example where, you know, because APIs are bringing, you know, it's real-time information, you know, immediate settlement, and ease of connectivity into systems. Interestingly, we've done a lot of work with the insurance segment. And the insurance companies had spent quite significant investment in reducing the time it takes to make claims under policies, using a combination of either automation and artificial intelligence. And so really looking to reduce the cycle time of what can be weeks to make decisions on claims to perhaps making claims payments before they've actually been made. We've done work, I think, one example in the travel insurance space, where insurance companies have used data, airport and flight data, which would then, from which they can gather real time whether a flight has been delayed beyond a certain point that a claim would then be valid. And rather than wait for that claim to actually be made by the policyholder, the person traveling, they would immediately make a decision to just settle that claim. Now, it was interesting because having really made such a huge step forward in creating that client experience for their policyholders, clearly also important then was to link that to immediate payment to us, to the policyholder's bank account. So we saw API-based connectivity connected into those decisioning systems to make the claims payment. And I can think of examples where, including a member of staff actually, who was stuck at an airport on the other side of the world and actually received their claim whilst they were still delayed and yet to make a claim. And that really brought an element of wow to the whole client experience that that insurance company brought to their policyholders. So again, you know, it's the immediacy of information, the immediacy of payments, and the use of real-time data, and bringing that construct together with API connectivity, that really changes the whole client experience basis that companies can bring to their customers.
And thanks. And certainly from my own experience, we are working for a company that makes PCs. And I think everybody can relate to the fact that even though we're basically B2B because we sell through channels, at the end of the day, people are buying these products and they, you have warranty claims, and that is an absolute nightmare for everybody and can certainly be greatly enhanced. Just switching to the other thing, which is, do I really need real-time information to run my treasury? And I think the general view coming out of our members is, well, yes, it would be nice to have, having real-time data is a nice to have, but I don't really need it and I can't justify a huge investment. And again, I think you've seen what's happened when people actually start having this.
Yes, I mean, I think one doesn't necessarily need to make a huge investment in order to achieve that end, but maybe a couple of points. Firstly, I think, given the pace of change that new technology is bringing to businesses, I think it is very important for treasuries to keep up or ideally actually be part of leading with their commercial business units to find these new opportunities that real-time systems and digitization brings as they create the sort of new business opportunities, such as the examples I've just given. So I think Treasury should see themselves at the forefront of that change. Otherwise, there's a lot to be done by treasuries in terms of actually making sure they're sort of keeping up with and supporting what their commercial businesses may be getting into in terms of the application of new technologies. But also, I think we shouldn't lose sight of the fact that treasuries are increasingly staffed with millennials. Millennials have grown up in an immediate, sort of instantaneous online experience world that's digital, that's absolutely paperless, and that's instant and immersive. And they're not going to expect any difference in terms of the way in which they operate, running a large treasury operation at a company. And I think, why would you not operate on that basis? And it's one without even looking at all of the value that accrues in terms of being able to more precisely, let's say, manage liquidity or payments risk or other timing risks that are inherent in the treasury platform.
So, and I think we need to wrap up on this segment. So, thank you very much. Would it be fair, Mark and John, to summarize this as saying, change is coming anyway, By the way, you know, when it comes to real-time treasury, we're all used to receiving notifications from our bank when a large payment is made out of our personal account. Why wouldn't we expect the same thing on the corporate account? So between the millennials, between what we're experiencing as consumers, and the fact that our salespeople are out there implementing new distribution channels. So is it fair to say the conclusion is that this is going to come and hit, and it's best to be ahead of it rather than behind?
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. And that concludes the first part of our series, Real Experiences with APIs in Treasury. So please tune in to our next episode, Low Cost, Incremental Change is Now Possible.